Mostly everything about the exam has been covered. I'll cover the other aspects. That is how to enjoy the process. People talk about persistence and so many other words. Basically, how do they develop? First of all, when are you happy? When you reach the target or when you're going through the journey? Obviously, it's when you're going through the journey. Okay, if you can't just say, I reached the target, so I'm very happy, then you would have missed most of your journey. All right. So, sir kept on telling about our group, right? He kept on telling I was always having fun, never serious in the class, because I've never seen a class like this. No, especially our class never used to be quiet. We used to always keep throwing questions and, keep talking to each other if the class is boring. So we used to do something. So that is what is needed. All right. So you guys are very quiet for my liking. Then, how I started? I started way back in 2010, as I told you. Basically, I'm an engineer. All right. So how did I develop interest in geography, history, and other subjects? What we did was, as soon as we joined, there was a faculty called Deepak sir, and Keshav sir was also there. So they made us form a group. They told us what is the importance of group, and we need to form a group. So we were from various backgrounds. So every day we used to come 1 hour early, or 1.5 hours early, and we used to teach in whichever subject we were experts in. For example, if I used to teach in science, there was a person from sociology who used to teach sociology. Okay, there was a person who was from geography background. So he used to come and teach that. So every alternate day, we made a habit. So that went on for at least about 3-4 months. We consistently did it. But then later on, then some people never used to find time and various other exams. So it kind of got discontinued. But that initial group which we formed was there all through the exam. And we used to miss the class. We used to miss the class. Many cases of classes I have missed. Reason being, we used to go for movie, or we used to go for hotel, just to have some KFC, just to have KFC or pizza. Domino's Pizza was there in Koramangala. So we used to go there. So this is what we used to do. But we always used to back it up. It's not like we missed a class and we never used to bother about that. We used to do that. Okay, so we used to always come. And one thing is how to keep yourself motivated all through. See, it's been almost 4 years. My preparation started 4 years back, exactly 4 years back, or maybe 1 month more. Okay, so still I'm persisting and still like doing what I like doing. Basically because of habit. In our training also, currently I'm undergoing training, so there also what we're made to do is we're made to repeat the same thing again and again. Be it firing, be it drill, be it indoor classes. They don't teach us much, but they make us repeat the same thing every day. That develops persistence, that develops a habit. Okay, so you need to repeat. And here the syllabus is so vast, you can't derail it, just touch a thing and forget it. Basically, we need to study very small. The syllabus which you make on your own should be very small, and you should repeat it as many times as possible. And as sir told, 90% of them quit after the first attempt. That is because they're not focused. They just want to take it up for the heck of taking it up. Okay, they're not really interested in making it in the IS post, or they give up because they lack confidence. And regarding one question which he asked about CA exam and CS preparation, it's like, see, in firing we have one basic concept. We can have a look at target, only one target at one point in time. Okay, you can only shoot down one target. We cannot have multiple targets and shoot at one time, unless until you are Rajinikanth. Okay, he is the only one who can do that. Got it? So no normal human being can be Rajinikanth. Got it? So CA exam is completely different from CS exam. There you have your own subjects to prepare, and it is really a Herculean task in itself. If you still find spare time, I would advise to read newspapers and still try to take this CS exam as a backup. Probably if you crack CA in the very first year or second year, then you'll still have time to prepare for your CS. So that is one way of approaching it. Okay, but you cannot do the same thing at one time. It is not possible. Okay. So that is one thing I wanted to clear out. With regards to overlapping exams, you can take up. Basically, Eastern Command exam, which I took up, was basically overlapping. Only thing we needed to prepare separately here was paper 2, which was basically English. Here we need to concentrate on essays and there are so many other stuff like PC writing, which you don't find in CS exam. But that is basically general in nature, which you don't need specific preparation. All right. So that is one aspect. Then any other question which you want to raise, which is other than, you know, the books you have to refer or other stuff. Like, he has answered mostly all the three stages, precisely how you go through prelims, mains, your interview. And with regards to interview also, there are certain things which you can always anticipate. And fear of failure should not be there in your mind. Okay, you should take this exam as if you are having a conversation with your elder, as if you are talking to your parents or teachers. That is how you should take up the interview. If you go there with a negative mindset, one thing they always check out is whether you are negative minded. They always put you in a dilemma. There are some questions which are confusing. You know, whether you should back the government view or you should back your own view. Okay, that again depends on your own self. Here they're checking your own intelligence, not, there's no textbook answers over there. You cannot give textbook answers. Because they know, there are people who have already served all through their life in higher posts. So they know each and everything. See, if you don't know an answer, you can always say, I don't know, and still get the best of marks. Okay, there are people who have scored more than about 75-80% of the marks by just saying, I don't know. But that also you should say with confidence. Okay, so even I don't know should come with confidence. That is what they look, basically. They want people who can handle any situation, crisis situation, with confidence. You cannot get into a quarrel with a general public. Got it? Suppose you are DM somewhere, or even assistant commandant, we always deal with crisis. So I cannot get into this hothead. I cannot get into a quarrel with a civilian. I cannot say, how dare you say this, or something like that. I have to always handle it in a diplomatic way. So main thing in interview is diplomacy, whether you can handle things or not. So they asked, one of the member asked me whether nuclear power is, that time Kudankulam issue was very much going on. It was in 2012, exactly 2 years back was my interview.
2 years back?
Yes, 2 years back, okay, 2012. The issue was about Kudankulam. The member asked me, what do you think about it? Should it be there or should it not be there? I said, Supreme Court said this, Supreme Court said that. No, as per them, it should be there. But she said, don't worry about the Supreme Court order. What do you feel? Okay, what do you feel? I said, it should be there. No, why do you feel that? What about the environmental aspects and other stuff? I said, if you want to grow as a country, then it is a must that you need to generate nuclear power also. And we must take all the safety, whatever measures are needed, along with it. Now we are in such a generation that we need power on a regular basis. So she was not convinced. Okay, even though I've given the right answer, pro-government, this is what people expect. But she was not convinced. She said, you're repeating the same thing. Okay, so there's nothing like correct and wrong in an interview. All right, but you should not be negative-minded. Okay, so any other questions? Anything which you want to know? I know you guys are all bored. You know, repeating the same thing again and again. Anything which you were like, See, interview was like almost 2 years back. I don't remember the exact questions, but as Manoj said, there will be people testing various aspects of your character. Okay, they want to know whether you get angry or whether you get sad about not answering a question, how confident you are. My interview was in PK Mishra board. Okay, that guy was very cool. He always, he's the one who is initiating. And basically what they do in an interview is they make you feel comfortable. As soon as they go in, they don't start shooting questions. Okay, there's something called as biodata, which you need to fill up. Okay, which you need to fill up prior to your interview. So that is one aspect which they look at. What games you have played, what kind of initiatives you have taken in your life. So these kind of questions are always asked. So you can't say, I don't know, or you can't sit quietly over there. You can't become numb to these kind of questions because this is expected from you. Okay, so this is your experience and you should share it. So that is one thing they ask. And there's nothing like, you know, you feel like running away from there. Nothing like that. It will always be the most memorable time of your life. You ask this to any person who has gone through the interview. Reason being, they share so much of knowledge that you'll always remember those things. Got it? Yeah, any other question? Yeah, please. Current affairs. See, current affairs. Okay, current affairs, see, newspaper is the only place where you can find current affairs. There are a hell lot of magazines. If you feel comfortable and if you can afford time, please go through them. Yeah. See, current affairs is not built in one particular day. Okay, you can't, it's not like engineering exam where you study the previous night and you just go and give the exam. It is unlike that, okay? So current affairs is something which is built each day, all right? So each day, whatever current happenings are there, you must always back it up with other data. Suppose today, say something like, take for example, the Jayalalitha case itself, as it is going on currently. So there, it is a current issue, right? There, what you need to learn is what about IT, income tax, how that department functions, just in a brief. Okay, there'll be a hell lot of questions on you can expect a question on this. See, this is how we build it up every day. Okay, and basically now they're not asking questions on this sports and all, so that part you can always eliminate. Sports section you can eliminate, but that will be needed for your mains. Okay, so you need to know about various sports. For example, 2011 or 12, they asked about Formula One, which happened in Noida. Okay, they asked, it was in mains. So the question was about flags, different flags used in Formula One. There's a checkered flag and red flag. What do these indicate? It was about 10 marks or something. Okay, so these kind of questions you should anticipate. You cannot say that this is the thing which will come. It is never like that. And conventional subjects, please try and repeat as many times as possible. History, geography, these are kind of subjects which you need to repeat. And environment, I don't think anybody can answer, even though you are a PhD. Simply because it is, the kind of questions they ask are so confusing and they need so much of knowledge. It's very tough to answer, according to me. Okay, so but the conventional subjects like geography and all you can answer. At least that you need to do well. And CSAT, as sir also explained, it is something which you need to, which is making the difference. After 2011, CSAT itself is making a difference. Because many of them who take up CAT and other exams are very comfortable with CSAT. They easily score 150 and above, easily. They are cracking close to 180 marks. And how much do you need to score as GS? Just a few more marks. Okay, so you are competing with these guys. Basically, there is no separate cutoff for paper 1 and paper 2. Got it? So cumulatively, you need to get through. But in mains, again, there is no use of CSAT. There is no maths there. Okay. Yeah. I hope I'm answering. In a day. See, that depends on you. CSAT, basically, if you are poor in maths, you need to do maths every day. Take up whichever topic you feel like and do the most simple problems possible. Don't go through any complex problem. If you go through your previous papers, you'll come to know. There's no necessity of doing any complex problem. But you need to do them daily because here, time will be a factor. In given time, everybody can score 80 out of 80 in CSAT. Given time. The difference between a CAT student and a normal student is time. They know how to manage time, we don't know how to manage time. Read it, frame questions, and ask the others to solve it. And then you can compare. Okay, there you can, because comprehensions these days are getting very long. And the kind of questions asked are like one or two. After reading a 10-minute question comprehension, you have to answer one or two questions. Whereas math questions are like, you can answer within no time. So that is how you need to target it. Paper one, you need to do it daily again. As many times, repeat as many times as possible. Okay. Not so. In Ascent Command, I'm the only one, but they have got into other courses. Yeah. See, one is currently he's working in Manipur. Okay, he's working as SDO there. He was the one who teach me geography. Okay, he's already got through there. And one guy has got a SI in BSF. And one girl is doing PhD in PubMed. Okay. I can say I was very lucky, that's all. I was very lucky. The guy who taught me geography he also got through along with me, but he had half a centimeter less in height, so he couldn't get through. Only that half centimeter. Basically, in Ascent Command post, they look for your physical also. You need to be physically and medically up to their standard, and it's very tough there. Getting through that part is very tough. Apart from your papers which you write. You need to be 5'5 in height for guys. There's so many other aspects. Pardon me? About the medical and physical. See, I used to write exams. I'll tell you one thing, which happened very recently in my training institute itself. One guy had applied for SSC exam. Okay. Here, all those who are training along with me are all aspirants of IAS and IPS itself. Okay, they are all wanting to do that itself. So he had applied for SSC exam. So in our institute, what happens is, even on Sunday, we have to apply for leave. To get out of the campus, you have to apply for leave. And they had not allowed him. Since they came to know that he's writing exam, they had even put him in his room. But what that guy did, he ran out. He wrote the exam. He came back in the evening. He very well knew that he's going to take punishment. Okay, and he took it for 1 week. But he went out, wrote his exam, and came back. That is because of his habit. He becomes so habitual writing exams that even when confined, he won't write some or the other exam. So likewise, I used to write all the exams possible, and I happened to get through this. This happened in the very first year which I wrote, 2011 itself, I got through. Okay, so you must take up all the exams possible and hope for the best. So I'm still persisting with my main aim, but I've got something along the way, which is not very less. Yeah. And one thing I would like to share from my training experience. One day we had firing it's somewhere in August or maybe July. In July we had firing. That happened in the first day of firing. We assembled there somewhere around morning, 4 o'clock. Okay, that is when the schedule starts, 3:30 to 10:30. So we assembled somewhere in the ground around 4 o'clock. That happened to be the hottest day in Gurgaon. Not only in Gurgaon, in north. It was somewhere close to 48 degrees Celsius. Okay, it was 48 degrees Celsius, and it is an open ground. It is not a closed ground. It's not a close shooting range. It was an open shooting range. Okay. So unfortunately for us, that day our DIG also came and sat. DIG is the principal of our institute. So he also came and sat. So there was no scope for hiding anywhere. So we were there entire day in that hot sun. Only thing we were thinking of was surviving that day. Forget the firing, we were thinking of surviving the day. But as soon as we landed up on the firing range, like meaning to say when we are about to shoot, our focus always used to be on the target. Okay, in despite of all the negatives which were prevailing there, but when we were in front of the target, it was only the target. Okay. So this exam is also pretty much like that. You have a lot of various other distractions. But when you sit to study, you must only study. Okay, that is how you must, I mean, people were asking about time management, how long do I study, and no, should I study 10 hours, 12 hours? Not needed. You study just 1 hour, more than enough. But it should be in a focused manner. You should be able to recollect those things later. It's not like I've studied everything, but I'm not able to recollect anything. That should not happen. Okay, so you must build up your own knowledge book. Whether you write it down or you put it in your head directly, it's up to you. But you must build up your own knowledge book. That is what keeps you going in this exam. Okay. See, basically without studying also I can attempt prelims. That is because I have built up my own knowledge book. Same with Manoj also, you can ask him. If you don't make him study for the next 1 year, he'll still take up the next prelims. Because he knows what is expected, you know, what I should do, what I should not do. Got it? The conventional subjects are mostly covered. There's nothing which is new thing which is going to add up over there. So all that I'll suggest is build up a knowledge book and keep revising it. And to build up that knowledge book itself, you need at least minimum 1 year. And then if you fail prelims the very next year, then you should not give up and, you know, walk off. You should try the very next year also. So if not possible, the third year. After third year, you'll easily know whether you can make it or not make it. Whether you're there or not there, whether your aptitude is there for the service or not. After that, you can pursue with your normal life. After that also, don't keep repeating that I have already put in 3 years, let me put in another 2 years. Then you'll become stagnated in your life. There are many of them whom you'll come across in Delhi who have put in all the, you know, whatever attempts, 7 attempts, 8 attempts, 10 attempts, whatever possible. Now they are not even employable in private jobs. Even private jobs look for experience. And these people can't go and sit in a clerical job because they would have studied so much, they feel that they should sit in some higher job, which is not possible. So don't do that mistake also. Okay, take 2-3 years, you'll know where you stand, and then pursue with your normal life. Okay? Yeah. Any other question? See, okay, I got it. See, our question is, how do you manage time in mains exam? There will be so many questions and there will be that much little time for answering the question. See, what UPSC wants to know in mains exam is whether you know the topic or not. Okay, whether you know, you have heard about it, not heard about it. All right, so that is what they want to know. And they don't expect an essay kind of answer. You're not supposed to write elaborately. You have to be to the point. Okay. So when you cut short your answers to the precise amount, that is when you will be able to answer all the questions possible. And that is what they expect. Your marks are given based on that itself. What people know, what mistake people do is, if I know a particular question, I try and answer entire thing about it. Okay. So that is where the time goes off. So how to do that is, basically you have to try and take up as many mock question papers as possible, mock or previous question papers, as many as possible. Then you'll know where you're strong, where you're weak, know where you're going wrong. And they should always consult with seniors who have already given mains or like, you know, teachers, faculty. They're the right person to guide you. Okay, never sit alone and analyze on your own. That is the mistake all of us do all the time. Okay, we think that we are far above everyone else. Now why should I go to someone? We always hesitate to take help. Always take help. And to the point, that is the main thing here. Writing speed matters. Okay, writing speed matters. You have to develop the writing speed. You can't be slow and neat. Okay, neatness also matters, but you have to fill in whatever question is asked. Basically, what happens between degree and here is, in degree, the same thing is repeated. You're studying the entire subject syllabus for one full year. You know the question, you know the answers. And basically there, they give you a lot of time. One question is asked for 10 marks. They make sure that 15 minutes is allotted for that. But here, that doesn't happen. They shrink that 15 minutes to just 7.5 minutes or 5 minutes. That basically, when you take up mains, you can always know that. Okay, and see, for example, 10 marks means 50 words. Let's take an example, 50 words. You have to fill in, try and fill it up as less as possible. You can even write in 25 words also. Yeah, it should be to the point. They've asked you something and you have covered it around the target, then it won't be possible. You have to hit the bull. Okay, you can't go around the target. You just write one sentence about it, which is meaningful. You'll get some marks. But if you write history of it, then you won't get any marks. That is how it is here. I hope I've answered that question. Then, any other question? Don't you guys have any hobby, like don't you play cricket or any other sports? I'll ask you questions now, okay? I got into this habit of asking questions. How many of you play cricket, by the way? Do you still play? Okay, yeah, you should play. Okay, if you have any game which you are very fond of and you play every day, you do play. Okay, you must keep your mind as cool as possible. See, that's what Manoj said. Having a stress-free life is most important for this exam. Okay. You should not be like, I have to cover a syllabus and you're doing it under stress. Then it's of no use. Okay, you won't recollect anything and it won't be of any use in the exam. You'll only waste your time and add more stress to your as it is stressful life. So that is what you should not do. See, recently we had a financial advisor who had come to our institute, okay, academy. He was talking about budget. Basically, financial advisor is his advisor to the prime minister. So he had come prepared with this budget. He was sure shot, but still he explained everything about budget, entire details, like how the money gets transferred. So I put a question to him. See, in the government infrastructure is the best possible. Okay, they build up such huge monuments, but there's no maintenance, lack of maintenance. Even for a tap is leaking, there's nobody to take care of it. So I asked him, what is the reason behind this? So he explained about plan, non-plan. Okay, how planned money is collected and how non-planned how expenditures happen. So the same question came in this prelims. Same question. Has anybody written this time prelims? There's a question regarding plan and non-plan. What are the non-plan, What are the non-plan details? Okay, subjects. So he had put in, anybody who had attended his lecture, you would have easily answered it, right? Easy question for you. So what I mean to say is, you have to, when such a lectures happen, you have to go back and analyze, spend a couple of minutes on internet. What is this plan, non-plan, what are the subjects under it? It hardly takes 5 minutes, but you must do it immediately. You can't, wait for the prelims, the answer to come, and then regret not going through this. He didn't say the subjects. He only talked about plan and non-plan and how they work. I came back, I have looked at it. Many of my friends looked at it. They went and easily answered it. For example, movie also. If you go to a movie, even there you have a lot of things to learn. Okay, people have attended my classes last year. I used to talk about movies itself most of the time. So there also have a lot of things to learn. And basically, this exam is not about like your degree exam where you have a certain syllabus, go through it, come back, read. Repeat the same thing. This exam is about every day-to-day happenings. Okay, you have to take everything along, which is, going along with you in your life. Link it and give it in the exam. That's all. Okay, all the three processes are very simple, provided you think it's simple. What happens is people have not, you guys have not even started studying and you are already thinking about optional. Okay, many of you are asking about optional. Okay, You haven't even put your first gear and you already want to go flying. Okay, first put your first gear, second gear, third gear. That is the most basic part, right? Anybody who can drive a vehicle in first gear, second gear, can easily drive the vehicle. He need not even know about third gear, fourth gear. Okay, so that is what I say. Take some time out, give some 2-3 months of preparation, then you will be the best judge of which option to take. Nobody need to mention that to you. Okay, take 2-3 months. Try and briefly cover all the subjects. Okay, history, geography, briefly. No need to go to, no need to cover up entire subject. Briefly go through, then go through your question papers, you'll easily know. Because I can say what is convenient to me. Okay, so but that may not be convenient to you. And in the end, that makes a lot of difference. Okay. Yeah. Any other question? Sir, then. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. And wish you all the very best, okay? Thank you.
On behalf of all the girls here, I have a question for Mr. Manoj and Pawan. Is it important for you to have a beard to become an assistant commandant?
It's supposed to shave every day. We are not supposed to keep beard in force. Okay, I'm just, since it's almost been the end of my, midterm break. Okay, we had holidays for a couple of weeks, so I haven't shaved since the day I left my academy. Because I'm so fed up of it, that's why I've not shaved it. Okay, as soon as I go back home, the first thing I'll be doing is that only.